Hello students, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So students, here I am going to start exercise 7.10, and as we have done first 5 questions in our previous video, so those who have not watched that video, please click on the I link. The description is given over there. From that video you can understand what is actually the substitution method and how can we find out the definite in solution of definite integral by substitution method. Following that method, let's proceed to question number 6. So the question number 6 is integration limit 0 to 2 dx upon x plus 4 minus x square. So first of all students, we have to just understand which type of integration is this, so that we have to apply that particular formula. So this is actually in the form of quadratic equation. So what to do? We have to make a complete square. So using the complete square method, the first step is that we have to make the coefficient of x square equals to 1. How can we make it equal to 1? As there is negative sign, so first of all we have to take negative common. So it becomes x square positive, x negative, and 4 also negative. Sign will get reversed. So students, in the next step, it becomes x square minus x minus 4. So students, we have discussed the complete square method also. From that method we know that to make it in complete square, we have to add and subtract half the coefficient of x whole square. So students, what's the coefficient of x? Here x, the coefficient of x is minus 1. So minus 1 half whole square, that means half whole square. So that means I have to add half of whole square and subtract half of whole square just to make it in the form of complete square. So next step is students, next step will become, see, using these three terms, that is x square minus x plus half, it becomes the formula of x minus half whole square. You can observe this is actually in the form of a minus b whole square. A is x square plus b square becomes half square. Minus 2ab will give you minus 2 into x into 1 by 2. 2 will be cancelled by 2 and we'll get minus x. Fine students, and the leftover terms are minus 4 and minus half square. So minus 4 minus half square, that means 1 by 4. So in the next step students, it becomes x minus half whole square, and taking the LCM of 4, 4 into 4 becomes 16, so minus 16 minus 1 becomes minus 17. So it becomes minus 17 by 4, which can be written as minus root 17 by 2 whole square. Now I hope that you have understood how we have interchanged this quadratic equation in the form of x square and a square. So again, shifting this negative sign inside, I will get 0 to 2 dx. Now this term will become positive, that is root 17 by 2 whole square becomes positive and it becomes negative. So students, we have done this particular type of functions in exercise 7.5. I have given the brief introduction regarding this, what are the particular type of integration and how to find out the how to solve this integration we have discussed in exercise 7.5. So if you want to watch that video, the description is given in the description box. You can just click over there. So students, the formula is that 1 upon a square, this is actually in the form of 1 upon a square minus x square dx. So the formula is 1 upon 2a log a minus x upon a plus. So formula is a plus x upon a minus x plus c. So using the formula, 1 upon 2 into a is here root 17 by 2 log a plus x, that is root 17 by 2 plus x, in place of x I am having x minus 1 by 2, upon a minus x, that is root 17 by 2 minus x minus 1 by 2, and the limits are from 0 to 2. So students, I am erasing this formula because we have done this formula in exercise 7.5. Particular type of functions are there for the integration. So next we have done the integration. 2 will be cancelled by 2. So it becomes 1 by root 17 log. Taking the LCM 2 in the numerator and denominator and cancelling it, I'll get root 17 plus 2x minus 1 upon root 17 minus 2x plus 1. Integration 0 to 2. So now students, we are going to put the upper limit, that is x is equal to 2. So putting x is equal to 2, I get root 17 plus 2 into 2 becomes 4 minus 1 upon root 17 minus 2 into 2 becomes 4 plus 1 minus putting the lower limit. So putting the lower limit, I put x is equal to 0. So it will become root 17 minus 1 upon root 17 plus 1. So students, it becomes log root 17 plus 3 upon root 17 minus 3 minus log root 17 minus 1 upon root 17 plus 1. So student, this is actually in the form of log m minus log n, which becomes log m by n. So it becomes log m is here as it is root 17 plus 3 upon root 17 minus 3. M by n, that means these term will become reciprocal. So it becomes root 17 plus 1 upon root 17 minus 1. Using the formula of log m minus log n, which is equal to log m by n. So this is the formula we have used here. So students, now further we have to simplify it. So in the next step, it becomes, now students will multiply root 17 into root 17 becomes 17 plus root 17 into 1 becomes root 17 and 3 into root 17 becomes 3 root 17. So it becomes 4 root 17 and 3 into 1 becomes plus 3 upon root 17 into root 17 becomes 17 minus root 17 minus 3 root 17 becomes minus 4 root 17 and minus 3 into minus 1 becomes plus 3. So further students, it become log 17 plus 3 is 20 plus 4 root 17 upon 17 plus 3 is 20 minus 4 root 17. Further students, you can see here that we can take common 4 from numerator and denominator. So cancelling, taking common and cancelling 4, I will get 5 plus root 17 upon 5 minus root 17. We have taken 4 common from the numerator and denominator. So 4, 5, that 20, and 4 we have taken common. So I'll get only root 17. Further students, we know that this is actually in the form of irrational number. So we have to rationalize it. So it can be written as rationalizing it. So it becomes 5 plus root 17 upon 5 plus root 17. So students, it becomes the formula of log 5 plus root 17 whole square, and in the denominator, this is actually in the form of a minus b into a plus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. So students, it becomes 1 by root 17 log. See students, it becomes a plus b whole square. And the formula of a plus b whole square is a square, that is 5 square is 25, plus b square, that is root 17 whole square is 17, plus 2ab, that means 2 into 5 is 10, and 10 into root 17 is 10 root 17. And in the denominator, we get 5 square is 25 minus root 17 is 17. So 25 minus 17. Now 25 minus 17 is 8. So we can just write down here 8. So students, in the next step, we can see 25 plus 17 is actually 42. 42 plus 10, both are in the form of 2. So we can take common from 2 numerator and denominator. So it becomes 21 plus 5 root 17 upon 2 we have taken common. So cancelling 2, I get 4 here. So students, this is the answer. Please note down. Next is question number 7, that is integration limit minus 1 to 1 dx upon x square plus 2x plus 5. So students, again this is in the form of quadratic equation, so we have to make it in the form of complete square, and this is also very simple question. So students, 5 can be split into two parts, that is, sorry, here I am having 2x. 5 can be split into two parts, that is 4 plus 1. So further students, we know that this complete becomes the formula of x, sorry, this complete becomes the formula of x plus 1 whole square, because x square plus b square becomes 1 and 2ab becomes 2x, and this 4 can be written as 2 whole square. So students, now it is in the form of integration of 1 upon x square plus a square, whose formula is 1 by a tan inverse x by a. This formula, students, you have done in particular type of integration, where we have done integration of dx upon x square plus a square is equal to 1 upon a tan inverse x upon a. So this formula we have used here. So half is a constant, better to take it outside. So putting the upper limit, that is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 upon 2 becomes 1, and putting the lower limit, that is minus 1, so minus 1 plus 1 becomes 0. So students, we know that the value of tan inverse 1 is pi by 4, and the value of tan inverse 0 is 0, because the value of tan theta is 1 at pi by 4, that is 45 degree, and the value of tan theta is 0 at theta is equal to 0. So now answer is pi by 8. Please note down. Next question is question number 8, that is integration limit 1 to 2, 1 by x minus 1 by 2x square e raised to power 2x dx. So students, if we'll just look to the integrand, we can see here this is actually in the form of e raised to power x fx plus f dash x. So first of all, I'm going to tell you, this is actually in the form of e raised to power x fx plus f dash x, whose formula is, or whose answer is, e raised to power fx plus c. This we have done in definite integral. See students, I am going to tell you, it can be written as 1 by x into e raised to power 2x dx minus integration limit 1 to 2, 1 upon 2x square into e raised to power 2x dx. As we can see, this is function and this is its derivative, so we don't need to solve the integration of this. It can be further cut. We will just solve this integration by parts. So by integrating by parts, we know that this function can be taken as first function and this function can be taken as second function. So integrating by parts, it becomes first function as it is, integration of second function minus integration derivative of first function into integration of second function complete dx, and the limits are from 1 to 2. And this integration will be written as it is. So now students, the integration of e raised to power 2x is e raised to power 2x upon 2. The integration of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Sorry, derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Integration of e raised to power 2x is e raised to power 2x by 2. Dx, integration limit 1 to 2, and now students, this integration will be written as it is, 1 to 2, 1 upon 2x square e raised to power 2x dx. So now students, you can see if I will split this integral, see this function and the limits are from 1 to 2 and this minus minus becomes actually plus. Integration, here I can again put the limit, the integration limit is from 1 to 2. So 1 to 2, 1 into 2 becomes 2x square, x square into 2 becomes 2x square, e raised to power 2x dx, and this integration is minus 1 to 2, 1 upon 2x square, e raised to power 2x dx. So students, I told you that this is in the form of this. You can see here that these two integrals are same, so it can be cutted. So finally, we have to find out the answer by just putting the limits in this function. So 1 by 2 is a constant, so better to take it outside. It is actually 1 by x e raised to power 2x, integration limit 1 to 2. So first of all, we are going to put the upper limit, that is 2. So the answer is 1 upon 2 e raised to power 2 into 2 becomes 4. And putting the lower limit, that is 1. So 1 into e raised to power 2 into 1 becomes 2. So 1 upon 2, half of e raised to power 4 minus e raised to power square. So students, we can take LCM. It can be written as e raised to power 4 minus 2 e square. So 2 into 2 becomes 4 and e square can be taken as common. So answer is 1 by 4 e square into e square minus 2. Next is question number 9. So students, this is can be done as, first of all, we can take x cube common. So it becomes x by x cube minus 1 whole raised to power 1 by 3 dx upon x raised to power 4. So now students, x cube raised to power 1 by 3. So cube into 1 by 3 will be cancelled, so it becomes x into x will be cancelled by x cube, so I get 1 by x square minus 1 raised to power 1 by 3 upon x raised to power 4 dx. So students, in the next step, this x will be cancelled by x raised to power 4, so it becomes 1 upon x cube into 1 by x square minus 1 raised to power 1 by 3 dx. So students, you can see here, this is actually the function and this is its derivative. So let us take 1 by x square minus 1 as t. Instead of t, I am taking t cube because t cube will be cancelled by 1 by 3, so it becomes very simple. Now the derivative of 1 by x square is minus 2 by x cube. The derivative of 1 is 0. Dx is equal to 3t square dt. Students, and again telling you that you can put here t also, but it will make your question very simple. So students, taking the value of 1 by x cube dx here, it becomes minus 3 by 2 t square dt. You can also replace the value, but just write down the function. So it becomes 1 by 3. So students, the value of this is t cube. So when I will put t cube, cube will be cancelled by 3. It becomes only t. And the value of 1 by x cube dx is minus 3 by 2 t square dt. So minus 3 by 2 can be taken as outside. T square into t becomes t cube. And the integration of t cube is t raised to power 4 by 4. Now this is actually the limits of x. Here I have not replaced the limits. So in place of that, I will replace 2 into 4 is 8. Better to take constant outside. In place of t, I am replacing the value. See, the value of t is here. 1 by x square minus 1 raised to power 1 by 3. So putting the value, 1 by 3 into 4 becomes 4 by 3. 1 by 3 to 1. So students, now I am going to put upper limit in place of x. So x is 1. So 1 square is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So 0 raised to power 4 by 3. And putting the lower limit, that is 1 by 3. So if I'll put 1 by 3, So 1 by 3 whole square is 1 by 9. 1 by 9 can be written as 9 minus 1 raised to power 4 by 3. So students, this becomes 0 minus 9 minus 1 is 8. This minus minus becomes plus. And student, this 8 can be written as 2 whole cube, because 2 cube is 8. So student, this cube will be cancelled by cube. So 3 by 8 into 2 raised to power 4 is 16. 8 cut by 16 is 2. 2 into 3 is 6. So answer is 6. So this is option number A. Option A is correct answer. Please note down. So students, next question is, fx is equal to integration limit 0 to x t sin t dt, then f dash x is, here we have to find out the value of f dash x. So students, you know that if I will take the derivative on both sides, I will get the value of f dash x, and differentiating both sides, so I will get f dash x, and you know that if I will take the derivative and the integration, integration is actually the antiderivative. So both will be cancelled. See students, it will be cancelled. Just we replace, we just put the value of this, that is limits. So this is actually very simple question. So replacing the value of t, it becomes x sin x minus 0. So answer is f dash x is equal to x sin x, which is option B. So option B is correct answer. This is very simple. Please note down. So students, I hope that you have understood all the concepts that we have done in this exercise 7.10, and you have understood question number 6 to 10. So in our next video, I am going to start exercise 7.11. So please watch that video also. Thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes. Stay tuned with us. Thank you.